play stupid games, win stupid prizes. What an interesting phrase, isn't it? Today, I'm sharing it in connection to President Trump's new decision about NASA's future. Yes, the ones who were playing with fire without thinking about the consequences are now facing the results. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. You know what? It's 2025, and the space race is blazing hotter than a rocket's exhaust. Private companies are launching payloads into orbit like it's routine, deploying thousands of satellites and sketching plans to colonize Mars. Meanwhile, NASA, the storied agency that once put humans on the moon, is staring down a financial cliff that could reshape its destiny and the entire landscape of space exploration. Earlier this month, the Trump administration unveiled a jaw-dropping proposal, a 2026 budget for NASA that slashes funding by 24%, dropping it from $24.8 billion to a lean $18.8 billion. That's a cut of over $6 billion, the largest single-year reduction in NASA's history, and it's sending shockwaves through the space community. This isn't just about tightening the purse strings, it's a bold signal that the era of big government rockets may be nearing its end, potentially ushering in a new age where private companies like SpaceX take the lead. But how did we get here? And what does this mean for the future of American space exploration? To understand the significance of this moment, we need to look at the contrasting paths of NASA and SpaceX. SpaceX, founded by Elon Musk in 2002, didn't have the luxury of endless funding. Operating on an estimated $10 to $15 billion over two decades, partly from private capital and partly from government contracts, SpaceX had to innovate to survive. That pressure led to one of the most groundbreaking advancements in spaceflight, reusable rockets. By developing the Falcon 9, which can land and be reflown, SpaceX slashed launch costs by up to 10 times compared to traditional, expendable rockets. A single Falcon 9 launch costs around $67 million, and the more powerful, Falcon Heavy, ranges from $90 to $150 million. Compare that to NASA's Space Launch System, SLS, which costs a staggering $4.1 billion per launch. SpaceX has flown over 300 missions, including astronaut trips to the International Space Station, and built Starlink, a network of over 5,000 satellites. All this while spending less than NASA's annual budget, which has hovered around $20 to $25 billion for years. The secret? Necessity. SpaceX didn't just want to save money. They had to, or they'd go bankrupt. That drive transformed the space industry. NASA, on the other hand, has operated under a different reality. With consistent funding, $25.4 billion in 2023, $24.7 billion in 2024, and $24.9 billion in 2025, 2025-NASA hasn't faced the same do-or-die pressure. While this steady stream of taxpayer money has supported ambitious goals, it's also fostered inefficiency. The SLS, in development since 2011, has consumed over $24 billion, but has only completed one test flight, an uncrewed lunar orbit in 2022. The Orion spacecraft, designed to carry astronauts, has faced similar delays and cost overruns, often seen as a companion to SLS rather than a standalone innovation. The Lunar Gateway, a proposed space station orbiting the moon, has oscillated between concept and reality, with experts doubting its feasibility. I'd like to quickly remind you to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. We regularly upload informative SpaceX and space news videos that you won't want to miss. Be sure to turn on the notification bell so you're notified whenever we release new content. These programs, central to NASA's Artemis mission to return humans to the moon and eventually reach Mars, have become symbols of bureaucratic bloat, soaking up billions with little tangible progress. For years, NASA doubled down on these legacy systems, banking on big, expensive, government-built rockets. But after more than a decade, the results are underwhelming. One Artemis mission launched, constant delays and human lunar landings pushed to the late 2020s or beyond. This brings us to the Trump administration's proposed budget, released as a skinny preview earlier this month. The $18.8 billion allocation for 2026, when adjusted for inflation, takes NASA's funding back to levels not seen since the early 1980s, a time when the agency's ambitions were far more modest. This isn't a gentle trim. It's a surgical strike aimed at NASA's most costly programs. The SLS, Orion, and Lunar Gateway are all under threat of cancellation or significant downsizing. The cuts are precise. Space science faces a $2.3 billion reduction. Earth science loses $1.2 billion, and legacy human exploration systems are slashed by nearly $900 million. Even NASA's sustainable aviation programs are on the chopping block, and the budget eliminates funding for diversity, equity, inclusion, and accessibility initiatives, which the administration deems misaligned. Acting NASA Administrator Janet Petro called the budget a balancing act between science, exploration, and technology development. But the subtext is clear. This is a fundamental shift in direction, one that challenges NASA to do more with less. Yet amidst the cuts, there's a glimmer of ambition. The budget includes $1 billion in new investments for Mars-focused programs, aligning with President Trump's pledge to plant a flag on Mars. This shift from moon-centric goals to Mars exploration is bold, but it raises questions about execution. How will NASA pursue such an ambitious goal with a reduced budget? The answer may lie in leaning on private companies like SpaceX. Elon Musk has long championed Mars colonization, and his Starship rocket, designed for deep space missions, could play a pivotal role. The budget's Mars funding could funnel resources to SpaceX, especially since Musk has announced plans to launch an uncrewed Starship to Mars in late 2026. This potential partnership highlights a broader trend: the private sector's growing influence in space. SpaceX's efficiency, building rockets, spacecraft, engines, and software in-house, stands in stark contrast to NASA's reliance on contractors and outdated systems. For the cost of one SLS launch, NASA could fund dozens of Falcon 9 missions or multiple Starship flights once it's operational. The contrast between NASA and SpaceX is stark when you look at timelines. SpaceX went from the first Falcon 9 flight in 2010 to landing and reusing boosters by 2015, just 6 years. In that same period, NASA was still in the early stages of SLS development, grappling with delays in assembling its core stage. Today, SpaceX dominates the global launch market, carrying over 80% of commercial payloads. NASA, meanwhile, has struggled to translate its hefty budgets into meaningful progress. The agency's critics argue that guaranteed funding has dulled its incentive to innovate, allowing it to coast on technologies rooted in the 1970s and 1980s. The proposed budget cuts are a direct response to this stagnation, signaling that the administration believes NASA's old ways are no longer sustainable. So, what does this mean for NASA's future? The cuts could mark the end of the big government rocket era, pushing NASA to focus on high-impact research and strategic partnerships rather than building and launching its own systems. This could make NASA leaner and more innovative, much like SpaceX. For example, NASA could invest in advanced propulsion technologies or planetary science, while leaving rocket launches to commercial providers. SpaceX's Crew Dragon already ferries NASA astronauts to the ISS, proving that private companies can handle critical missions. Other players, like Blue Origin and Rocket Lab, are also advancing rapidly, offering NASA more options for collaboration. This shift could accelerate progress toward Mars and beyond, leveraging the private sector's agility to achieve goals that have eluded NASA for decades. However, the transition won't be seamless. Critics warn that the cuts, particularly to science programs, could jeopardize NASA's role as a leader in discovery. The $2.3 billion reduction in space science threatens planetary missions, while the $1.2 billion cut to Earth science could hinder climate research, a critical area given global environmental challenges. The Planetary Society called the 24% budget reduction the biggest single-year cut to NASA funding in American history, warning of an extinction-level event for some programs. Scientists and advocates argue that NASA's mission isn't just about launching rockets. It's about advancing knowledge, inspiring future generations, and tackling existential questions about our place in the universe. Slashing funding risks undermining these goals, especially if private companies prioritize profit over pure science. The broader context adds another layer of complexity. The Trump administration's 2026 budget proposes a 23% cut to non-defense discretionary spending, affecting agencies like the National Institutes of Health and the National Science Foundation alongside NASA. This reflects a prioritization of defense and homeland security over civilian science, a move that has sparked debate. Space exploration has historically enjoyed bipartisan support, with both parties championing NASA's mission. The proposed cuts could face resistance in Congress, where lawmakers have often ignored similar proposals from Trump's first term. However, White House officials suggest that Republican lawmakers are more open to these reductions now, raising the stakes for NASA's future. Despite the challenges, there's potential for renewal. The budget cuts could force NASA to shed inefficiencies and embrace a more collaborative model. By partnering with SpaceX, Blue Origin, and others, NASA could focus on what it does best, pushing the boundaries of science and exploration. The $1 billion for Mars programs, while modest compared to the cuts, signals a commitment to bold goals. If NASA can harness the private sector's innovation while maintaining its scientific leadership, it could emerge stronger, ready to lead humanity to Mars and beyond. SpaceX's success shows what's possible when... Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.